Neutral is not a good position to be in as far as behaving for God or the Lord Jesus Christ. We need to behave in alignment, whether you might be said as cold or hot, but do it behaving in accordance with the Lord Jesus Christ. He said, "You are lukewarm. I am on the point of spewing you out of my mouth, rejecting an unpleasant drink or piece of food from my mouth." That's what it was like to the Lord Jesus Christ when he viewed the behavior in that church in Laodicea. It was like something he needed to spew out of his mouth. It was neither cold nor hot. And he continues and says, that you say, "I am presently wealthy." What you're saying about yourselves is that I'm rich. I'm wealthy. And I was wealthy and continue wealthy. My method of action, the way I behave, is rich. I am rich. And I have not one need. I don't have a necessity of anything else. I don't need anything from anybody. I need nothing else. And you did not know, you did not perceive that emphatically you are. You yourself are the one who is distressed. See, the Lord Jesus Christ knew exactly what was going on. Even though they may have tried to portray that they're wealthy, they don't need anything from anybody. However, the Lord Jesus Christ said, "I know that you yourself are one who is distressed. You are enduring toil and hardship. You are wretched, miserable, and more to be shown mercy. You need mercy. And poor, you are beggarly. And blind, you don't see where you're going." Of course, that would be referring to seeing the truth of God and the things of God. "And naked, unclad." That would refer to not wearing your spiritual clothes, putting on those things that God and the Lord Jesus Christ would want you to have in the spiritual sense, so that you would behave appropriately. And then the Lord Jesus Christ says, "I give counsel to you." I'm giving you advice. Let's see what advice he was giving to them. "To buy or purchase from me, let me be the source of what you're purchasing. Gold, which has been set on fire, from fire, ignited." In other words, it has already been refined to the purest sense. "Come to me, buy from me that pure gold, for the purpose and result that you would be wealthy, that you would be really rich from my viewpoint. And white outer garments, clothes that are emitting that radiance, that light, for the purpose and result that you would clothe yourselves." You know, not be naked, but to clothe yourselves with the outer garments, those white outer garments that I would give to you. "And the shame pertaining to your nakedness," you know, would not be manifest or shown forth. It wouldn't be seen. Why? Because it wouldn't be there anymore. "And the salve to anoint your eyes," you know, as rubbing your eyes, putting something on your eyes, you know, as opposed to the medicine that some people were receiving for healing, you know, or maybe putting makeup on their eyes to demonstrate their physical riches. See, the Lord Jesus Christ was giving them advice to come to him for what they needed, to realize, yes, they did need his help. They did need assistance from the Lord Jesus Christ. They were experiencing toil. And he says, "And the salve to anoint your eyes for the purpose that you would observe." He wanted them to see, to be observant, to understand the information that God in himself was giving to them. That would be in relation to the spirit category. He continues and says, "Emphatically, I, as much or whomever I would be loving, refute." The Lord Jesus Christ proves their behavior to be wrong. And that's what he's doing right now. He was pointing out to them where they were wrong and what they should do to correct it. You know, he wasn't being mean to them. He was telling them what they were doing in giving them advice. And he says, emphatically, I, as many as if ever, whomever, I would be loving, and that's loving with the brotherly love, I refute, you know, I prove their behavior. And I train as a young servant. He goes in and disciplines them or corrects them. And following on logically, you must be zealous. Be zealous. Have a boiling or vehement passion. And you must repent. Change your mind from those works that you were performing, whether, you know, they were lukewarm, evidently, that's what he said. So change your mind, rethink the matter and change your mind and then behave appropriately. He said, look, I stood and I remain standing, I'm knocking. Oh, you know, a lot of times when the word knocking is used, especially in the Old Covenant times, it wasn't a literal, you know, using your hand and hitting against a wooden door or something. It would be that they're using their voice in calling out to the people inside. Look, I stood, and I am not knocking. If it should happen at any time that someone would hear my sound, listen to my voice, and he would open the door, allowing me access. And that's the Lord Jesus Christ talking, allowing me access to go inside. I will go into his house towards him, and I will eat a meal with him, and he with me. And that shows that relationship, that intimate relationship that the Lord Jesus Christ would have with the person who allows the Lord Jesus Christ entrance, who would believe him, accept what he says, do what he says, allow him access. I will eat a meal with him and he with me. The person being victorious, the one who is gaining the victory or conquering, I will give to him to sit down in company and association with me. Where? In my throne. Yes, the Lord Jesus Christ has that regal position, that throne or chair of authority. So I will give to him to sit down with me in my throne in comparison to how I also was victorious. The Lord Jesus Christ has already been victorious. And he says, to how I was victorious, and I sat down in company and association with my Father on his throne. God granted the Lord Jesus Christ to sit down on his throne. How beautiful. And the Lord Jesus Christ was letting the people know that the one being victorious, he will also grant or allow to sit down on his throne. The person having an ear must hear what the Spirit says to the churches. Again, that is to listen attentively to the words that are being spoken and which John wrote down. Now this is the last of the seven prophetic writings to or for the angels in their different churches, which began in Revelation chapter 2 and verse 1.